Hello everyone and welcome to another edition of New Tech Tuesday Tutorials, and y'all know me, I'm Richard Evans, and today I'm going to be showing you a feature that a lot of people are excited about that comes with the new TriCaster 2 Elite, and that is called Live Call Connect. Live Call Connect is a way for you to bring in multiple callers from all sorts of video conferencing applications like, for example, Zoom, Microsoft Teams, Slack, Tencent, Discord, and many more, and then bring them into the TriCaster where you can manage them like you would a camera source physically plugged into your system. Similar to how Skype integration for previous TriCasters work, it will also automatically manage the audio to and from your callers with a built-in audio mix minus. You can also use Live Call Connect to bring up web pages to showcase in your production or for monitoring sites. But enough talking, let's get a rocking. Okie dokie, so here we are in the TriCaster 2 Elite interface. And this is where we're gonna go to, you know, switch our show, etc. But then I also have a second monitor plugged in that I have configured as my multi-viewer, which typically is used for monitoring our program, previews, different inputs, media players, scopes, etc. But what I wanna do is I'm gonna change this screen into our app desktop so that we can have access to our apps that are compatible with Live Call Connect. So to do that, we'll go to the top of the screen on our interface, under Workspaces, and under Multiviewer 2. We'll open up Load Default, and these are all the different configurations that I can choose on the Multiviewer, but I'm going to select the very bottom one, which is App Desktop. Brand new feature here, and this allows you to basically start to go through and use different applications within the TriCaster. So only a few compatible ones here. So one of them, for example, will be Microsoft Edge, so you can open up a web browser, check newtech.com for all the latest and greatest information from NewTek, yeah. Or you can also monitor your stream, for example, and then also check your email and Facebook, etc., blah, blah. Okay, now you'll also see at the bottom of the page here that I also have a few apps installed. I have Skype TX and Zoom, but you can also use Tencent, Discord, Slack, and Microsoft Teams, and then start to bring those into your broadcast via Live Call Connect. Now, I'm gonna keep this very, very simple today, and I'm just gonna use Zoom. Right? And I am going to start up a meeting. Now, I'm gonna fast forward this part so that I can invite a couple of callers in here. All right, so now we have our callers coming into our Zoom meeting. So let's click on View here and admit all of them. And let's go ahead and collapse this menu on the side. We don't need that anymore. And now we have our simple Zoom call with our three different callers in here. So I have my caller number one, also caller number two, and then I also have my TriCaster coming through as the return signal over to our Zoom callers. So this is gonna be what our Zoom callers are gonna see on their end. Now that's always gonna be the program output of the TriCaster, so keep that in mind. So now what we wanna do is configure this application to then send our Zoom callers to different inputs on the TriCaster. And to do that, we'll go to the top of our Zoom call, and then you'll see here that I have a new little gray box here, which is gonna be for doing exactly that. So let's click on this gear configuration icon here, and select Assign Callers to Inputs. And then after that, we will click we'll click Live. Now, when we do that, I want you to take notice of my cursor here. That has now turned into a circle, which means I can now do nothing to this particular Zoom call. So I am locked in here. And so the preferred workflow when setting this up with Live Call Connect is to set up all your calls first, and that way you lock them in place and you are good to go. Now let's take a look back over onto the TriCaster TC2 Elite interface. And now check it out. Now I have inputs coming in on input 9, 10, and 11. Okay, so let me go ahead and I'm gonna make a few adjustments here because I don't have a caller number 12. Let's go ahead and set that to black. And then also you'll see input number 10, that is the return feed that was coming to my Zoom caller. So let's go, from the TriCaster to the Zoom caller. So let's go ahead and set that to black as well. But the nice thing about that was it went ahead and just automatically brought in these inputs. Now, if you're wondering why it brought them in over on input 9 and going down instead of going onto input number 1, etc., it's because your inputs 1 through 8 by default are going to be set to your SDI hardware inputs on the back of it. So that way you don't accidentally overwrite something. Now, you can move these around however you want. So for example, let's go ahead and open up input number 1 settings. And on this drop down, we'll go to our local sources, and beneath our SDI inputs, you'll see we have options for a Skype TX caller, test signal generator, web browser, and Zoom, which is what I have installed. And if I click on caller number 1, so it now brings in a duplicate that I can use however I want, which is awesome. Now I'm gonna set this back to black and leave it the way it is. So what's cool about this is you can now treat these like regular camera sources and use them however you want. And then I can also embed them into virtual sets. So for example, if I turn on their keyers here, Ultra, there we go. That, and now I have these Zoom calls embedded into some different virtual sets. For example, on my mix effect number 1 and mix effect number 2, which is pretty dang cool. So now I can use these as I normally would just any other video source. Now I did want to mention as far as audio is concerned, let's go down here. So your audio is going to be coming through on input number 16 where it says apps. And if we open up that configuration, you'll see that I have 8 different channels to work with here on this system. You also have access to the processing tab for EQing, compressing, etc., and also using the routing table so that you can route your different audio sources around. So, Live Call Connect, a great way to bring in remote guests from all over the world, no matter what their favorite video conferencing application they prefer. Now, this is a game changer and one of the many awesome features that comes exclusively with the TriCaster 2 Elite. Now, I hope this video helps to expand your new tech knowledge, and if you're looking for some more new tech brain candy, subscribe to our YouTube page at youtube.com/newtechinc. And for more information on all of our new tech products, contact your local reseller, or you can visit our website at newtech.com. And we are also bringing you a ton of cool content over at newtech.tv. Everything from new tech product announcements, demos, interviews with new tech users, third-party developers, and so much more. So please check that out. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time for the next installment of New Tech Tuesday Tutorials.